Robin DMV. We are the
Migo Experiment.
Yo soy La Bori.
Willie B.
Visions by Diego.
Henry Flo.
And we're just gonna go ahead and get straight into this week's
This drink right here, look. Check it out. I don't know what the fuck this is. Yo, Bori, please explain that jungle like what we just ate.
Yo. First of all, I'm into juicing foods now, so I juice my pupusa. It's a lie. I'm kidding, y'all.
Don't no, it's not a bateado, it's a bobitao.
I'm lying, y'all.
Tell me why that don't look like the same color for thing,
right? It's
matching.
Well, I like to eat what I wear.
So you know what you eat.
Yeah, exactly.
What is it though?
But
what
basically is this is a mango turmeric madness.
Mango turmeric, okay, a fancy name. What the fuck it got, yo? Like does it have like a pupusa?
Yo,
like,
obviously, no.
Real like, time, it's like you're lying to me. For real, it's pepperoni pizza, yo. That's what it is, yo. She just fucking liquefied that.
First of all, that's trifling.
That's not like the baby Gerber.
No, no, carrots.
Sweet potato joint.
Yo, y'all sleeping on me.
What's the ingredients? You gotta know what you're drinking.
Mango.
Okay.
All right.
Turmeric.
What's turmeric?
What the fuck is a turmeric?
It's like a spice. Like you use it in your
cooking. Turmeric with tamarindo. What the fuck
tamaric.
Is it?
Turmeric. Google that. T-U-R-M-I-C. Oh, shit. Wait.
Y'all look it up because I don't even know what that shit is.
T-U-M-E-R-I-C. Turmeric. Okay. What did that spell? Turmeric?
Oh, shit.
But anyway, so it's mango, turmeric. Orange juice.
She didn't even know what you
pineapple.
Uh-huh.
So what the fuck does it do? Detox or some shit?
Does it give you like a una buena turia? Like does it hurt?
Una.
I'm saying it cleanses you, right?
I plead the fifth. But yes. It gives a good internal cleaning.
Nice.
There you go.
Just so you know. So the throw, like this throw up looking thing has its benefits.
Yeah.
They've been coming at me all day about it, but you know what? I don't care. I'm still drinking it.
Speaking about benefits, man. So what's up with this George Zimmerman trying to benefit off, you know, Trayvon Martin's family again, man? Like, y'all know what's going on? Can somebody explain what's going on with
so
that?
So literally, this man is really suing Trayvon Martin's family. The family of the son that he killed, he's suing them for $1 million.
What?
Actually, was $10 million.
It's $10 million.
I thought it was 100.
I thought it was.
Wasn't 100?
Is it? No.
Million. I swear it was. I don't know, bro.
You know what?
What's the reason for it?
This is the best way to confirm it.
I swear it was like
for cost million. And for time of his life that you know has been costing him so much. Is what it is, you know. No, I mean, personally, I think he's a fucking.
He's a moron. He's an idiot.
Fuck that. He's like the sweat look. Okay, the guy that I don't know where.
100 million.
Right, I was right.
I'm sorry.
100 million. He's suing him for $100 million. That's some wild ass shit, right like, there, man. I don't even. Know.
That's kind of that's really
that's
fucked up.
Heartless. You killed the fool, and you're trying to sue the family.
That's heartless.
That's fucked up.
They were in the wrong and in self-defense. And they actually, the thing about it is he actually has an amount of people that actually believe that. You know what I mean? Believe that it was self-defense, that he was just doing the right thing. And he still wants to take advantage of that and try to sue the family. Like, he's like, yo, no tenés compasión, dog. Like, for real, like, yeah, I hope you do burn, bro. Like,
no,
I hope you, it's fucked up, but.
It is. And the thing is that, like, I feel like, what? It's kind of like, you want to be rewarded for taking away, like, the son of, you know, someone's son?
Like, he's not resentful for that? Like, dude, you took someone's life.
There was there was literally this one comment. Because, you know, like you said, like, there's people who actually, like,
support
George Zimmerman. There was actually a comment
where
this guy was like, okay, like, there's no reason to sue. Like, justice won. You weren't charged for defending yourself. So why sue? So there's even the people who were defending Zimmerman, it seems like they're even speaking out saying, like, why is he suing this family?
Es como que está estorbando el panal. You know, like, he's messing with that honeycomb, man. He's messing with it. Like, he got away safely already. But he's still gonna be poking at the honeycomb, yo. They're gonna those bees are gonna bite your ass.
I think he's just trying to make money off this.
And watch those bees come back and bite his ass, dog. Karma's a bitch, bro. Like, okay, you got away the first time, cool, whatever.
I don't even know why we giving this full fame. Fuck him.
Nah, man, it's just like, dog. Man, he's a pecozón ass candidate, bro, for real. Pecozón, loco. Y un vale verga, loco, porque vale verga, loco. Real talk. You got a vale verga and a pecozón. Just like that, dog.
100 times.
Yeah, man.
1,000 times, really.
And that's not worry about that.
You can join your Diego.
Diego, man, hey, make that joke sound like una metralleta. Come on, man. You're at the very end, dog. I used to do this.
Hey, make that joke sound like the Rambo movie. I just watched that shit yesterday.
Remember that?
Shit, the new one?
New one? You went to go see the Rambo movie? You will go see the Rambo movie.
Shit, that shit was good, though.
For real?
That was actually pretty good. I like it.
Shit, movies, Rambo, for real?
Rambo, the last
He was worth it, though, his old ass in that joint. He still did the whole joint with the... I haven't seen it. Don't tell me.
Yeah, my man still cold-blooded.
Yeah, he's still cold-blooded.
He's still cold-blooded.
He's still, you know, being drug out of shit.
Nah, he ain't put the red bandana, he ain't do none of that shit.
He put out that, like, the vicious knife?
Yeah, he pulled out the vicious knife.
Ah, yeah, okay. Damn, Rambo. Damn, I was... You know how fucked up my childhood is? Yo, let me tell y'all, right? Like, I ain't see, like, Disney movies, like Disney Plus and shit, like, now. I'm actually catching up on that now that I'm a viejo. I used to get taken to go see Rambo, Terminator. Those were my kid movies that I remember from my life. Friday the 13th.
Halloween.
Fucking, Halloween. Like, it's
those
just like.
Those aren't Disney movies, though.
Fuck no. Comando, nigga. The joke on Arnold Schwarzenegger and stuff. And what's the other joint? Predator. Remember that joint?
Yeah,
those are the movies I got taken to before I was 5. Like, you know what I mean? Like, like, bro, I grew up off of that, dog. Bambi, fuck Bambi. Kill that bitch, skin it.
I
like,
that shit.
So I go to the barbershop, y'all. They're like, yo, yeah, I never seen Bambi, dog. You never seen Bambi? I was like, nah.
You know what? To be honest, I've never really seen Bambi.
No, I haven't. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't either.
I've only seen, like, the beginning.
Well, both of y'all are young.
That shit was like the fucking kid movie.
Only,
they even showed it in school. Yeah,
I only saw the beginning, like when the mom or dad or whoever the hell it was.
It was the mom.
When, was
died.
It the mom?
Mom
died. I don't know. Someone told me it was a dad.
Mom died. Dad, he ran away. Mom died.
All I know is that they never had a bunch of girls banned, so they're mostly like strippers and.
But they named Bambi. Chilla,
yeah.
I know a few.
I don't know no Bambi. The only Bambi I know got a big butt.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
God. You're perverted, buddy. Kyle, what's wrong with you,
man?
Speaking of Disney Plus, you know they're going to put the gargoyle on their Disney Plus.
I know you happy Joy over there, aren't
shit,
you?
Shit, hell yeah, man. That's my childhood shit.
Man, shit. If they turn the gargoyles into like the like an actual like real life, so they turn all that shit real life. Now they got Dumbo in real life. They got Lady and the Tramp in real life. You know what I mean? They turn the gargoyles into real life, yo. What?
Yeah, I know. Dope. They're making a whole bunch of movies. Like, I know that Mulan is about to come out next year. That's actually one that I really want to see because Mulan was one of my favorite Disney movies. So, I really
want to. The way she was like, this is one of my favorite Disney movies. She even had that swing right now. It's okay.
I held it in.
It's my favorite.
My shoulder
twist. That was her time fucking Elsa, young, from Frozen, young.
That is not my time.
I was
grown
when Mulan came out.
Right, dog? You know, Mulan was at the new shit.
Okay. Sorry.
And that damn prince of, the prince of, whatever, the llama looking joint.
Oh, the Empire's New Groove? The Emperor's New Groove?
Damn.
That's their generation.
I love that movie.
I was fucking Five Goes West. You know what I mean? I was fucking American Tail ass motherfucker with the little mouse. You know, somewhere out there. I singing for his daddy and shit in the moon and shit. You know what I mean? Like him.
The Land Before Time.
The Land Before
Time. Oh, Land Before Time with the dinosaurs?
That.
Damn.
I used to watch it on Cartoon Network when it would come on.
You kind of look like a Triceratops, dude. Look like a little baby Triceratops, dog.
Oh, my.
He was a beast, though, dog.
Oh, what was the name of the main character? Littlefoot?
Littlefoot, right?
Yeah.
Turn the camera a little bit over there. I'm a producer.
I'm having know, like Bigfoot.
Oh, shit. Can we pick up the caravan on Bigfoot?
Hey, call me Harry, motherfucker. Bigfoot
over there.
Oh, shit. Harry and the Great. What is it? Harry and the Jeff. What the fuck is his name?
I'm great.
The big old. Remember what I'm talking about?
Nah.
The Bigfoot show. Harry and the Hendersons. There we go. Harry and the Hendersons. There we go. Yeah, I still remember.
Damn, but you know what? Y'all will never, like. I don't know. 10 years ago, everything was just so different.
You're still crawling.
It was, first of all, shut up. Second of all, everything was just so
She's still eating Gerber food. Look at that shit.
Things Gerber, don't change. Gerber some life. Things change, some things don't.
Gerber life, that's a lot of little sweet potato joint right there. That's
a sweet potato flavor. Things change, some things don't.
She looks old because she looks old.
You know what? Like,
yeah, she's really like 12. Looking like 24 and shit.
Thank you. But you know what? Like, 10 years ago, I did not look 12. Like, if anything, I don't even know how to say it.
Fuck it. Just look at the pictures. Look at all of us, like, 10 years
ago. I did not look anything like I do now. Some of y'all actually look the same. Yeah. Me, I didn't know.
She was in a school. I'm trying to tell you, we actually had this during the chat. Y'all like, get a mop.
I was not in the school.
Yeah, you want a little skinny little thing? Little cool caliente.
Oh my god, bro.
Cool caliente. Hey, what's the other word? Culo cagado.
Little cool cagado over there.
None of that.
With the shitty diaper hanging on the button. No,
I'm
kidding. I don't want to have your mom be like, yo nunca tenía mi hija así. ¿Qué te pasa? Look at this baby. He was going bald then.
Who's this? Can we take a guess who this is?
I don't know.
Can we take a guess
who this is?
Yeah,
that's
right.
That's me.
Hey, he's zooming on his face.
Literally.
Zooming on it.
He got a little peach fuzz going on his face.
Right? He still got a peach fuzz. It got bigger.
He had a little peach fuzz on his head. His chin.
I don't know what happened now.
His lip.
Soy más guapo.
Ay,
es que creciste, pero creciste para los lados.
Ahí está. Ay,
comete esto.
But you know what? I'm curious to see what Diego looks like.
I'm glad I ain't had no phones on my phone.
You probably look like one of them little Habibi kids.
my man was in diapers. He was still in diapers.
He was online.
Oh,
no,
bro.
Yeah, look like, oh, you know what? You probably look like Mowgli. Mowgli from The Jungle Book.
Which one? Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Hey, they got the same sideburns.
That's
true. Shit, all three of y'all got the same sideburns. What the fuck you mean, Sam?
Why you gotta do me like that?
I had
the fucking trapo on my fucking.
Which way? You look at the cartoon like shit, though!
Hey, if anything,
when you are not Habibi no more, you are Mowgli, nigga.
Hey, pull up, Goldie.
Look, this is the live action joint.
Hey, pull up, Go Diego, bro. I
didn't
look like Go Diego.
Nah,
give me that shit.
Go Diego, go for what? Dora
looks for him? Damn! I look like him.
You like Diego?
I did the little cheetah joke whatever.
Nah, bro. I say if we vote.
Hey, fool, so your name ain't Diego. Your name probably like fucking. Fuck them or something. For real, yo. He's gonna start Diego and go Diego. You know, he's like, my name is Diego from now on. Ustedes no me van a llamar fuck them, okay? Me hacen burla en la escuela. So I'm about to spit.
Bruh. Oh, shit.
Oh, man.
Oh.
Chill.
Yo. Oh, damn. So, should we call you Mowgli or Diego?
Diego.
Okay.
Man, these 10-year challenges. I don't know. Why are that joke getting popular now? This is getting popular.
Because, well, like, one decade's coming to an end.
Fuck that. It's because all this shit now that's available, yo. Like, man, like, you can get surgeries, you can get operations.
What does that have to do with it? No, it's because the decade's coming to an end.
That's why it is?
I think so. That's my opinion.
Is it written in the Bible? People will start showing the 10-year challenges before they fucking die. Before the end of the world. No, like... Nah, it's because there's so much shit available, man, and people look different. And nowadays, I guess the people who are getting old, like my ass, like, what the fuck, man? We look different. We do.
Here, this is Henry Flo's babyface. Bro, one job. My punch face.
Oh shit.
But wait, there's more. Look, that was like his signature. One job. Oh my gosh. Look, it was literally your signature.
Yep.
One job.
Bro, one job.
Mean, he was like, smell it.
Yeah. Hey.
Yes.
Hey, like, smell it.
Hey guys, he was like,
we going to the top. That was the joke. We going to the top.
Hey, I man. Like smell it better.
Smell it.
Can I make it look like a Nike logo? Smell it. Just smell it.
Un pedo, loco.
Smell it. Hey, man.
I'm posting that on my story. Just smell it.
Bro, we gotta make some shirts now. Just smell it. Just smell it.
Hey, you heard it here first.
Right. Wow. I'm done. Migo experiment!
Hey, oh,
wake her ass up, you fucking pizza pepperoni up in this bitch here.
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Ay, Dios mio.
Hey, man, speaking of telling your talent, man. Alright, look. I was on Snapchat, I saw this story. You know, it was a 23-year-old male married or a couple with a 56-year-old male. That's a huge gap.
So it's two guys.
Two guys. Uh-huh. 123, 156. He's damn near 60.
He's half his age, literally.
Yeah.
So it's basically his dad at that point. True. It sound like
one firm and one soggy.
And there's just a relationship. Like, I mean
how you know? How you know there's a firm one and there's a soggy one, bro?
Age difference.
Hey,
he was very. He was observing.
He might be. He might be at Don Lucas, dog. That Italian dude. What's his name? Is that Lucas? Lucas.
What about that?
You don't talk about the DJ dude, the one who was a sugar daddy young, the one who dances and moves his hips and shit.
Yeah, I know he's talking about.
Fuck is his name? He's like Don Lucas or some shit, right?
But yeah, how y'all feel about that though? Like having that huge gap within. Like, do you think that's true love or that dude is just a sugar daddy at that point? Like, what do you think about that?
That's the love for the money.
So hold on. So you're saying that if it's okay, this is a man and man, okay? I understand what you're thinking. So you're making that a whole point of
the age difference
that the young person's always trying to get over on the older person.
Well, even
whether it's girl guy,
a girl guy,
guy girl, whatever,
free for all, whatever. I don't care what it is. If it's young and old. There's always going to be money involved. It's never love.
Cause I mean, the story was they met on Tinder, and they just fell in love that way. But I'm just like, what? Like, do you guys feel
you get on Tinder? You go on Tinder just to fuck.
I mean, if anything,
from experience.
That's the purpose of Tinder.
You saying this from experience, buddy?
Well, I didn't say anything.
No, I said Tinder.
You
was like,
she was trying to make a point. She said, "I mean, she's trying to say something."
Thank
else,
you, though. Mowgli. So what I was trying to say is that, like, I mean, there's very, very, very few chances. That usually, I mean, it ends up being love. There's very few chances. But overall, let's say, like, there's 98%. Like, in a relationship like that, 98% maybe is for the money. But there's that 2%.
Damn, that's a 2%er? What the fuck?
Well, this is not accurate. This is just body assumptions. But that's what I think. I think that there really is, like, that small amount that really end up, like, you know, doing it because they actually do fall in love, like, you know, with each other. But I feel like overall, like, most of them, it's gotta be.
So in this case, the lifestyle, it's the money, they
gotta
like it.
Be for the money.
They like
the
fact that. So
let me just spitball here. Let me just play devil's advocate. So what would be an age appropriate, like, time, like an age?
Like what's not too?
Like 2 years, 5 years, 10. Like
What's the gap? What's the gap? Safe.
From what I'm understanding. In general, you guys think that if it's an older and younger,
I mean, that's
it's for the money, period.
Most cases are like that.
In most
cases are like that. It's like, you know, if they want to go that route, that's on them. But, like, you know, it's never a happy ending. Just
I mean, there's a happy ending, many happy endings, probably.
I mean, the happy ending only lasts for like a week, and then.
Mind you, this couple been together for 6 years.
Hold on. Did y'all catch that? You know, the happy endings last for like a week, and then you know what I said. You gave a lot of happy endings for a week's worth. And
no,
then,
what I'm saying.
Boom! Is it's just like, you know what? It's the same happy ending all the time.
I was gonna say like you never know how soon like the person dies, like the older guy, girl, whoever it is.
Who the fuck are you, Frank from Shameless and shit? You ain't dealing with people about to die and shit.
No, like, I'm not dealing with no. I'm just saying, like, cause you know what? I did read this story. Of this lady, like this like famous model or whatever in Europe, that she ended up marrying some business executive or whatever, and she was 22 or is 22, I don't know, but she was 22 and the guy is 74. So basically, I mean, you know, whatever. So they got married. They were like seeing each other for like 2 months. Then they got married. And then he ended up dying like a month later from their marriage.
Damn. He fucked that man to death.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I said, you know, I mean, there could be happy endings.
I mean, but like, you know, I actually had to. This was actually an actual question that I had on my show, right? Like, when I used to have the show and stuff. Like, it was like, you know, is it love or is it interest? And I actually got a lot of phone calls of like females that are like, you know, I met my husband when I was like 23, 24, and he was like 63. I'm like, what the fuck? And I'm just like, you know, that's like your father. That's kind of weird, you know what I mean? But she's like, you know, he's 63, but he doesn't look it. He looked like he was in his late 40s, blah, 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 when I got with him. And I've been married with him for 10, 15 years now with his kids and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what the fuck?
Man, how the fuck?
And they're like, you know, many people were like, is it in today? But it was just like, I just wanted a man who was stable at the time, and he was very stable, and I found him attractive and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, what the fuck? And I fell in love with him.
Well, you do know how they say that, like, men don't mature as fast as women do or whatever. I mean,
damn,
maybe,
but she's 23, she's 63. What's maybe, a 40-year gap between our maturity or something?
That's what I'm like. I'm like, well, maybe he was at his prime mature. Like, she was like, that's what I want.
I mean, but that is true. You know what I mean? Because, like, think about it. Like, you know, like, a lot of us are in the scene. You know, you see a lot of guys, whatever age group we may be in, like, you could turn to the next side and look at the dude. Are they doing a lot of stuff that we're doing?
Mm-hmm.
You know, are they mature? Some may not. You know, so look at the female. Are they going with that? But then there are some females that are attracted to losers. There's a lot of females that attract to losers, so they might overlook the fact that there's a guy that got his shit together, and they might go for the loser because they like getting treated like some shit.
That's true.
Trash.
That's facts.
Very true.
That's facts. Right?
And there's a lot of them out here that love getting treated like, you know?
He knows. He's single. He's in that market. I don't know any of that shit. Right?
That's from like, experience.
They put a hook in me a long time ago, yo.
Oh, shit. Man,
they caught that one fish.
Yeah. I was fighting, goddamn! I was fighting. Ah, no!
There was a big fish over
here. Oh, shit. Yeah, dog.
She caught you by that finger. That's why
it took 10 years of moving in, dog.
That's why you got that finger out.
Yeah, like,
so she got me.
You was the Meg.
E.T. Go home.
Ah. He's the one.
Smelly.
They had to go deep sea diving.
Right? Fuck you, dog. But they found me, though. It's like an oyster. I was a pearl.
Little mermaid.
Shit, as a matter of fact, I just saw that on Disney Plus. So, yeah. Little Mermaid, the remake.
How many of you guys got Disney Plus?
Right here.
Is it worth it?
Yeah,
it is.
It is.
Shit, I've been watching X-Men. No. Oh, like, you know the...
I don't know what's happening.
That's
been a reading.
Yeah. Flo knows it, see?
It was a General Fox. It was a General Fox.
Damn, what you watch? I know you watched X-Men when you was younger.
Look, the reason why he never tried to live that type of lifestyle because he was out already selling cafe on the corner block outside of like a BA or that Kumo. That's why that's what he was doing at that time, yo. You got the word chocolate. Hey. Oh, that was the Swiss Miss. Making money though, yo. $2 Swiss Miss, young, is a come up. Hey. Let me tell you, yo.
Quesadilla.
I think he's the only one that can relate.
Tamales, nigga. What? What you mean? My mom was a tamalera lady, dog.
I feel me.
People who done never worked in their lives can't relate to that shit, yo. We kids out there, we were put like through kid labor, yo. Like, nah, there was no
child labor laws because of us.
Right?
And flop iba la porbosa, vender tamales.
I did. Charamuscas, actually, dog. What? Yeah. And what?
Charamuscas. You know what charamuscas is?
La tia had pupusas over there. You know with them with the mantel and shit, yo. With the big old tub of fucking curtido, yo.
Hold on. That should be hit. Body don't know what charamuscas is.
Charamuscas. It's like a fucking, you know what pop ice is?
A popsicle?
It looks like a boli, yo. What the fuck?
What's a boli?
Oh my god.
Yo, wow.
Yo,
you never had pop ice. You know what pop ice is? Pop ice. Like, it's literally like the ice.
Pop popsicles. Ice?
Pop someone needs to educate her. Someone educate her. Also,
no, there was a fly that flew past.
There's a fly.
It's a puppet.
It did look like that, though. I saw it, though. No, I saw the fly. No, you know what I mean? This man was it.
David Sison.
Yeah, you're about to throw it.
Basically, it's a Salvadorian.
Why don't you? You need to be on camera, still talking behind the camera, asshole. Like,
so it's a Salvadorian treat.
Hey, show this man a face real quick, right?
It's a Salvadorian treat. It's an ice treat that is put like in a sandwich bag without the Ziploc, and it is tied. It's made in like strawberry, vanilla, coconut, different flavors.
Or the chata.
So
they put it in a bag, like the liquid form, and then they tie it up.
They freeze it.
And they freeze it.
They call it charamusca. But it doesn't come in a bag. Like, it usually comes in cups.
Limbes? Do you sit there and blend?
Basically, you be popping it out. Like, you kind of like, it's frozen. It's like this. Like, it'll be
as
like this.
As a melt, you come, you know.
Oh, you push it up?
And you, like, you just pop it up and you, like, suck on it.
Oh. Ours was charamusca, but it came in a bag. Mm-hmm. See, we're convenient. We put it in the bag. Like, what you trying to say?
We're not convenient? Are we sloppy?
Hey. I don't know. You know what, though? I never said that. It's just.
You know, it's funny, like a lot of people, even like a salsa,
we put it in a bag.
That's what I bought.
That's gonna be fresh. That's what I'm doing. Right? Even like a salsa.
Squeeze that drink.
I didn't say all that.
You were doing this, so I'm gonna do this.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Nah, but it's funny, like a lot of Latin American countries got.
Their own way.
They got, yes, but they also, for the same dessert, they got different names, you know?
Yeah.
Like even fruits. Like, I know in Puerto Rico, a naranja, they call it China.
China.
Yeah. Like, a uva China.
And no, it's not the song. Yeah.
So, it's the same thing, like, you know, like mamones. In El Salvador, mamon.
Isn't that quenepa?
Uh-huh. And quenepa in Puerto Rico, in DR, is called limoncillo. So,
yeah. Doesn't some places be calling like a banana, like guineo, mm-hmm. and some people just say banana.
Well, in El Salvador, they call it guineo too.
Yeah, yeah, I'm saying that.
We say banana.
People say like, we say guineo, and then others say banana.
I mean, we can say guineo too, but like, usually, you more commonly, you'll hear banana.
Yeah.
You know, to each their own.
How do you guys say passion fruit?
Passion fruit? We'll call it
guayaba.
Guayaba? That's what you guys call passion fruit?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
You learned something new, huh?
Huh?
You learned something new.
Who?
You learned something
oh,
new.
Oh, yeah.
Like, let me ask you a question. In Puerto Rico, like, what's your special drink other than conquito?
I mean, like, there's... Well, for a fact, like, my favorite drink is Malta. Like, Malta, you know, there's Goya, like, Malta. Goya makes Malta. But, personally, over there, like, more people drink Malta India. I feel like that tastes way better, in my opinion. Then there's also like jugo de parcha, like passion fruit juice.
So jugo de parcha.
Parcha.
So I thought
parcha. 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 P A R C H A. Yeah.
Pichar. P-A-P-A what?
P-A-R-C-H.
P-A-R, where the hell's the R at? I ain't hear no R. I
well, have you know what? That's not my fault, okay? It's not my fault. I was born like this. I'm broken. Anyways. And then there's also like this drink called Mavi that they usually drink. It's kind of like, I don't know how to explain how it's made. Like, it's kind of like, but it's kind of like a non-alcoholic beer taste, kind of. Like, I think it's made from, like, tree bark, if I'm not mistaken. But if you drink, like, a lot of it, you'll get buzzed. But it's pretty good.
Hold on, you're gonna get some bootlegger stuff. It sounds good. There's also pitorro, too. Speaking about moonshine and stuff, pitorro, yo, what the hell do we call our moonshine like Salvadoran? TikTok.
Yeah, you can make it out of pineapple peels, like anything fermented, like potato peels, anything that's fermented, but usually it's made out of pineapple. That's kind of like the lazy way of making alcohol, because that's usually let it age, you know what I mean, versus they actually distill it.
Nah, they let it fermentate, like they let it, you
that's
know.
The lazy way of making alcohol. I want that shit distilled like the way, man, like white people from like Kentucky.
But I
mean, the moonshine drink. I've been doing it, my grandpappy did it, I did it too. You know what I mean? I got to watch the cop all the time. We make some good moonshine out here.
That's kind of like, that's really kind of like the
throw. Oh, hillbilly ass over there.
Oh, shit. We should make some moonshine amigo experiment.
The next week, that's my episode for real, man. So check it out, y'all.
We will not be making no moonshine.
Moonshine!
It's water.
The producer's talking, guys. Yeah,
hey, yo, but if you still want to actually have us make something like that, or we'll try one day, you know, hopefully, I don't know if we can actually get a license to do it. They're shaking their heads. Just comment on the bottom, and we go ahead and actually try to make it happen. Go ahead and subscribe, y'all, to the
Migo Experiment.
Yo, follow me. I'm Henry Flo underscore DCF.
I am Labori, LABORIIIDMV on Instagram.
Erdon Welly.
And Visions by Diego.
That's right, man. Yo, hashtag, man, Migo Productions and hashtag the Migo Experiment. Tell your friends about us, man, that we... Yeah, we're pretty raw. But still, yo, you like it. It feels better, don't it?
We're good raw. We're that raw that you like.
That's what she said.
We're keeping nothing warm.
We out.
Yo, thank you for everything, man.